Say a prayer, say a little common sense. Stay right there in our defense. Give a little bit, give a little bit more, just a little bit, babe, a little bit more. You're amazing.
So here we are backstage, as production's getting sorted out. It's Sean Maestri behind us, our dedicated and devoted drum tech. Sean's been with us since basically day one. Back when we used to tour in a van with just him and Dan, as a matter of fact. So
here he is. Actually, I'd like to say that the first tour that Donkey did, actually, we were in a bus.
Yeah.
Really? Sorry.
Yeah, I don't tour with vans.
Street cred out the window.
Street cred erased.
But we have done van stuff with
him. Yeah, we have been in a van with him.
He came into
and he did sit in the shitty seat.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, he's a little spoiled brat
kitty,
now.
Kitty.
Living the high life. He's always stoned.
What would you say?
I'm kidding. Sean's our drug-free drum tech and a really great guy. And anyway, so here we are in Kitchener, Waterloo, Ontario. Really excited for the show this evening. Apparently it's sold out and nobody else can get tickets. But try anyways if you haven't gotten them and you're watching this within the couple of hours before the show starts.
Right now we're getting the drum set ready. If we get it up to 85 and down this ramp today, I think we're going to take back off to 1865. But
I'm just showing Sean.
Hey, how was your days off?
Oh, my days off were really nice. I kind of just spent most of them in bed. I did a little bit of walking around and tried to shop, but kind of was a little too distracted and indecisive, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, kind of the same. I took a little bit of the advantage of we're having gorgeous weather right now. We hit Ontario a couple days ago, and sun was shining, literally, and it was nice and warm out. So I took a walk around, and I just watched a bit of Kung Fu. I watched, for $8,
like
I got
show?
A double feature. No, I watched a Showdown in Little Tokyo with Brandon Lee and Dolph Lundgren. Followed up on the other side by Bloodsport, which is probably one of the most classic kung fu movies.
Yeah, that's pretty
of all time.
I remember being this tall and just so impressed that Jean-Claude could split
splits,
his legs
yeah.
on those chairs.
It was awesome.
Tom, as soon as you see a man's legs part like the Red Sea, he gets all pumped up.
Get all fiery and worked up, sweaty.
Yeah.
On a way.
On the other hand, I did not watch Time Cop.
You didn't go on a job.
I did.
You didn't take the Jean-Claude Van Damme exit on your Kung Fu Highway?
No, I didn't. No.
We're going to come take a look at the venue here.
We're still setting up. You can kind of see from behind.
That's Dan. He's an actual giant.
Where's my meat?
Funny if the thrust was like over 6 feet.
We usually do a marble check by putting a marble down and seeing if it rolls. But
I just do it to play marbles. This background that we have on our screens right now always reminds me of those
popsicles.
Oh, like
all the
colors the Itchy-Kazooie or whatever.
Reminds me of that really colorful parade they have in Vancouver every year.
In springtime, right, Tom?
Right.
Anyway, thank you guys for thanks so much for paying attention to us still. And we're having a really good time and hope you can join us. Guys,
we're in London tomorrow, I think.
Yeah, we have London tomorrow and then we've got Toronto on Monday, which is a pretty big day.
Yep.
So we're really excited. And
Toronto's the biggest show of the tour.
Yeah.
And then Montreal, which is probably the second biggest.
Uh-huh. That's actually a true statement. So we have actually some pretty exciting shows coming up in the next little while. So please stay tuned. And if you haven't checked out whether there's tickets available, there probably is somewhere we can squeeze you in. So, thanks for stopping by.
Okay, cool.